Hi, today we're going to talk about how to use Blink. A lot of times we ask for a quick demo or an example. How does the platform actually work? So I thought I'd take a few minutes and show you just the basic functionality around Blink and how you can jump in and quickly create links. So when I first go into Blink, here's the dashboard. So up here underneath New Link, I can choose this here, and it's going to give me two options, a branded link or a dynamic link. So dynamic links, again, are the way you can route. So a single click, you get routed to different destinations based on day, date, time, language, geography, or device, or any combination thereof. However, in this case, we're just going to create a simple branded link. So a branded link is, again, from point A to point B. So I'm going to put in my long URL here. In this case, I'm just going to example.com. I have a default 6-character keyword. Now, the keywords here, call this example, just for our demo today, but I can put in multiple keywords here. I can separate them by hyphens, dashes, underscores, dots, etc. So you can really create the perfect link exactly as you want it structured. Our link description, this is just our free text field. I can type in anything, any kind of text here. It's all searchable, so it's a great way to reference that. Our URL builder, so really different templates around Google Analytics. I have different ways I can manage this all again through the admin. I can choose it from a drop-down, different components here, or I can also do a free text field where I can just type it in real time as I'm using this. So we also support doing custom templates, so you can have multiple templates. You have custom templates for Google, for Adobe, any analytics platform, any way you want to structure to build a perfect link. We'll have another video that goes through that in much more depth. Over here on the right-hand side, we have ability to tag our links. So anytime I tag a link, that's filterable, so I can change that based on the download. I can download by tag, I can filter by tag on my analytics. So it's a great way to structure your links and have multiple tags either shared across your entire organization or individual just to you. Notifications means we're going to send you a link, sorry, send you an email for the first 10 clicks of that link. So we're not going to send you 100 emails if you get 100 clicks. After 10, we'll turn that off, but it lets you know that somebody is clicking on your link either one time, or maybe you have a link that you've put out and it's going to take several days or weeks for it to see the public, and you want to know that the traffic is flowing to that link. It's a great feature just to let you know that there is traffic flowing. We also support two different redirect types, 307 and 301. And so there's different reasons why you want to use one or the other. You can check our knowledge base to walk through that in more detail. But both of those links are options are available for you. And then we also have date actions. So date action allows you to set an archive link date. So if I set this date as say tomorrow, then today this link will redirect to exactly where I pointed it to. After tomorrow, it's going to redirect to the home page that I specified in my root pages in the admin. Now, delete link, instead of right redirecting to the home page, it's actually going to delete that link to purge the link and all the data out of the platform as if it never existed. And this is really common across our customers that integrate Blink with our SMS campaigns, where they might be doing thousands or hundreds of thousands or millions of links, and they want to make sure that those links are not in the platform long term. Maybe they're only going to be clicked on for the next 7 days, the next 30 days. And so they want to automatically purge those, one, to keep their platform clean, two, to keep their costs down. And three, to make sure that they don't have any loose links that are out there that could be clicked on in the future that might go to someplace that is not appropriate for their organization any longer, where that might be, say, a dead link or a system that's been decommissioned. So being able to do this automatically, again, through the browser, through the API, is super powerful. Private links allow you to basically you have to be logged into Blink before we do the redirect to the destination. So you have a link that's, say, internal only, that even if someone were to discover it, they have to be authenticated with Blink before it gets redirected. And then last is link masking. So being able to put a mask where we're loading the destination URL in an iframe and only displaying the short link in the address bar. So these are just a few of the core features of Blink that you can jump in and see real quickly how to create and add a link. So in this case, I've created my new link. My short link is now blink.training/example. So I can see here's my long URL. Here's a short link I've created. Everything we do is through SSL. So we have HTTPS links. Here's all the information. And again, as a reminder, everything in the platform is editable. So I can come back in here, I can change everything. Let's say as a quick example, I just wanted to update, remove that trailing slash. I can change the owner information, I can change the redirect type, the date action, etc. I can reset my clicks or even delete the link together. So I click on update, now my link is automatically updated and all my traffic is going to flow to the appropriate destination. So that's the real basic information, how to use Blink out of the box. If you have any questions, please drop us an email, help@bl.ink. We'd love to answer them for you. Have a great day.